Hello, kids. How are?
Kids
Hi, I'm Zoe. Kids have taken over from the adults. So now let's hand over to Michael and let's listen to him read the Bible verse for today.
Hello, my name's Michael. I'm going to be reading from 2 Timothy 3 verse 15. And how from infancy you have known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus.
Thank you, Michael. Now, let's pray. Lord Jesus, thank you for this wonderful, happy life we have. Thank you that you created this world just for us. We would not know what we would do without you, God. Amen. Now, let's worship. He's our rescuer. Hey!
He's our rescuer. He's our rescuer. We are free from sin forevermore. Oh, how sweet the sound. Oh, how grace abounds. We will praise the Lord, our rescuer.
There is good news for the captive. Shame. There is good news for the world who walked away. There is good news for the doubter, the one religion failed. For the good Lord has come to seek and save.
He's our
about Jesus' early miracles. So, stay here, pay attention, and I'll see you in a minute.
Jesus traveled to Capernaum with his disciples Simon, Andrew, James, and John. He went into the synagogue on the Sabbath and began to teach. The people there were very surprised. Jesus' teaching was not like the scribes' teaching. He spoke with authority. Just then, a man with an unclean spirit shouted, "What do you have to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." Jesus commanded the spirit to be quiet and come out of the man. The spirit yelled again and then came out. Everyone was amazed. "Who is this Jesus?" they asked. "He teaches with authority, and the unclean spirits obey him." News about Jesus spread quickly throughout all of Galilee. Next, Jesus and his disciples went to Simon and Andrew's house. Simon's mother-in-law was in bed with a fever. Jesus went to her, took her hand, and healed her. She got up and began to serve them. That evening, large crowds of people came to the house with others who were sick or bothered by evil spirits, and Jesus healed them. Early the next morning, Jesus went out by himself to pray. Simon and the other disciples found him and said, "Everyone is looking for you." Jesus said, "Let's go on to the nearby villages so I can preach there too. This is why I have come." Jesus traveled throughout Galilee. He preached and drove out demons. A man with a skin disease came to Jesus. He got on his knees and begged, "If you are willing, you can make me clean." Jesus was willing, and he healed the man. Jesus' miracles proved that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God. They strengthened people's faith and met their needs. Through Jesus, God did what is impossible for us to do on our own. He provided forgiveness, salvation, and eternal life.
Wow, that was a great video. Jesus did amazing miracles, didn't he? Did you know he can still do miracles today? If we pray, he can make us better. If any of you have a story of when Jesus healed you or someone in your family, please let us know. And now we're going to go and have a game and a craft. Hello everybody, my name's Liam and today I'll be doing your game. For this game, you will need a pen and two pieces of paper. I'll give you 15 seconds to go and get those things. Okay, good. Now you've got your pieces of paper. Put one of them on your head and I will describe something that you need to draw on it. Not on your head, on the piece of paper. Okay, let's start. The first thing you need to draw is a square. Then, on top of that square, draw a triangle. Inside the square, on the bottom of the square, draw a rectangle. Are you done? Okay, good. Does your drawing look like this?
No, my drawing doesn't. Mine's a bit bad.
It's okay. I'll give you another chance. Okay, draw a circle in the middle of your piece of paper. Okay, good. On one half of your circle, draw two smaller circles inside. On the other half, draw a half of a circle. Okay. Does your drawing look like this?
Ooh. No. Mine doesn't look at all like that.
Ooh.
I hope you did better than me.
Okay. Hope you did well. Please send us your photos of your drawings. Thank you for playing. Bye.
Hello everybody, my name is Sam and this is...
Martha.
Hi Martha. Martha and I are going to show you a craft today. Now, this week we've been learning about the amazing miracles that Jesus performed. And we've been particularly looking at how Jesus healed people. So, today's craft is a little craft to remind you and remind maybe others, friends or family members, of the amazing things that Jesus has done to heal people. And so what we're making is little paper plasters, and you hopefully will have had an email with the things that you need to print it off. So we've got a sheet with some paper plasters to colour in. Top plasters say Jesus heals, and the other ones say Jesus Christ has the power to heal. And then there's a little cut-out box that you can keep your plasters in. Here's one we've decorated. And the idea is you can keep your plasters in the box, and you can give a friend or family one of the plasters with their name on and the thing that you are praying that Jesus will heal. So we're going to take you through that. So you will need your bits of paper. There should be two sheets on an email. You will need a glue stick, a sellotape, scissors, a snack, and your colouring pens and pencils. So the first thing you can do is take whichever plasters you like. You can even draw your own, but you have to use the printout ones. And Martha's going to show us colouring in. So Martha, are you going to decorate the plaster for us? So Martha, what colour are you using?
Purple.
Ah, great. Ah, we're going to do the other side now. We've chosen a pink. And to finish off, we've got a little red heart in the middle. Everyone can see.
Yes.
Yeah, that's great.
Great. So, yes. And finished. This
lovely.
This is how I done my first one. You can do these any colours you want to do.
Great, thank you, Martha. Now we're going to cut it out. That's a good point, Martha. You can get help to do the cutting out if you need it.
Help to glue, help to colour. If it's taking too long,
and we have
a plaster!
Lovely, let's zoom in. Beautiful plaster. I think that beats your princess plasters, Martha. Let's move on and colour in, and then we will stick together our plaster box. Okay, so we started colouring in the box. We've got our cross. Good idea, Martha. What else are we going to put on our box?
Please come. Oh, I got orange. So if I just colour in this.
We've got some little Bible verses you can look up together and read about.
You can read about this one if you want to. Can you read it?
That's right.
Do you know what green and orange makes?
Brown. Good quiz question.
Brown. Maybe this is hot.
We're going to cut it now, having finished colouring. Now, it is important that you cut out all the tabs so you can glue them together. So if you need a grown-up to help you, make sure you ask them.
He's purple, but...
So, Martha is going to glue the tabs together so we can make it into a box. So all we need to do is fold it together. That's it. Great. Fold it all together. That's right. And you'll need glue to stick it. So you need glue on. You glue there. We're now gluing the bottom of the box together using the tabs. You can use glue or sellotape. So we've got our completed box and we've got our decorated plaster.
Wow.
Goes inside. You can have as many as you like.
You can have 3, 2, 1, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. How many have you got?
How many have you got? And what you could do is write the name of the person that you are saying a prayer for, who you want them to feel better. That might be your friend or family. And we ask Jesus to make them better. And to help them know that you're praying, you can give them one of the plasters to remind them that Jesus heals. Okay, well, we hope you enjoyed doing your craft with us. Are you going to say bye-bye, Martha?
Bye.
Thanks for the game, Liam, and thanks, Sam and Martha, for the craft. Don't forget to send in your photos. We'd love to see them on the shout-out next week. And don't forget to keep sending in photos of your booklet so you can get the next badge. I've got mine right here on my lanyard, Joy. Hopefully you got yours, but if you didn't, don't worry. If you haven't done January, you can catch up. And if you have sent us photos, it will be coming your way. So remember, this month we're working on the badge Faith. And we're going to show you a couple of photos of people that already have their badges. See you in a bit. Guys, I really hope you had fun with the children's takeover today. Please make sure you send in all the photos of your craft and the game. So bye, that's all for now.
I wonder where Marillo could be.
I think I got away from them. Hopefully next week we'll be back.